हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट बुद्धिज्म। नाउ हियर इज द सीक्वेंस इन विच वी विल लर्न बुद्धिज्म। वी विल स्टार्ट विथ लाइफ इवेंट्स ऑफ बुद्धा, देन वी विल लर्न अबाउट बुद्धिस्ट फिलोसफी, देन बुद्धिस्ट काउंसिल, आफ्टर दैट अर्ली बुद्धिस्ट स्कूल, एंड देन बुद्धिस्ट फिलोसफी बाई अर्ली स्कूल और संघ, एंड देन हीनयान एंड महायान बुद्धिज्म, एंड then Buddhist text, and next is Bodhisattva, and after that Buddhist monks, and next Buddhist architectures, and in end we will learn about decline of Buddhism. So we will start with life events of Buddha. Gautam Buddha was born around 563 BC in Lumbini, Nepal. He was born when his mother was in journey, and his childhood name was Siddhartha. Gautam Buddha died around 483 BC at Kushinagar in Malla Janpad, and this event is known as Mahaparinirvan. Father of Gautam Buddha was Suddhodan. He was leader of Shakya Kul and king of Kapilvastu. The mother of Gautam Buddha was Mahamaya, and she was princess from Koslan dynasty. And she died when Buddha was very young. So he was raised by his foster mother Gautami, and Gautami was sister of Mahamaya. Gautam Buddha was married to Yashodhara, and he had a son named Rahul. He left his house at the age of 29 to become ascetic, and this event is known as Mahabhiniskraman or the Great Departure. He got enlightenment or Nirvana at the age of 35 at Bodh Gaya under a peepal tree on the bank of Niranjana River. He gave his first sermon at Sarnath, and this event is known as Dharmachakra Pravartan. Lumbini, the birthplace of Buddha, was built by King Anjana. He was king of Koliya clan, and he built the city Lumbini for his queen Rupa Devi or Rumindi. In Buddhist texts, Lumbini is mentioned as Pradimoksha Vana, the forest that is free from sins, also known as sin-free forest. So the life event of Buddha is represented by symbols. His birth at Lumbini was represented by lotus and bull. The great departure at the age of 29 from Kapilvastu is represented by horse. Enlightenment or Nirvana is represented by Bodhi tree. His first sermon or Dharmachakra Pravartan at Sarnath is represented by wheel, and his death or Parinirvana is represented by stoop. In last lecture, in Jainism, we have seen the term Nirvana. In Jainism, Nirvana is associated with death, but in Buddhism, Nirvana is associated with enlightenment. And for death, the term associated was Parinirvana or Mahaparinirvana. The Buddha was mentioned by different name in different texts. Siddharth was his childhood name or original name. He got the Gautam Buddha name after enlightenment. And Buddha used Tathagat word instead of I or myself in Pali texts. And in Asokan inscription, Buddha was mentioned as Sakyamuni. And there is a book named Light of Asia written by Sir Edwin Arnold. So Buddha is also known as Light of Asia. So in this slide, we will learn why Buddha left his palace at the age of 29. Before the age of 29, Buddha used to live a confined life. At the age of 29, for the first time he came out of his palace on a chariot, accompanied by his charioteer Channa. On his journey, he observed four scenes. The first scene was an old man. And Channa explained that it was consequence of aging. The second scene was a sick person. So Channa told Buddha that all human beings are subjected to disease and pain. All human beings or all living beings are subjected to disease and pain. The third scene was a dead body. Channa told Buddha that death is an inevitable fate. And the fourth scene was an ascetic. And in this scene, Buddha find a path of salvation. Next day, Buddha decided to leave the place, and he left the place on his horse Kantaka, accompanied only by Channa. After leaving his palace, Buddha wandered over different places and he learned meditation. So Buddha learned meditation, Spear of Nothingness, from Alara Kalma, and he is considered as first teacher of Buddha. He was monk of Sarmana tradition, and he was considered as first teacher of Buddha. After that, Buddha learned another meditation of formless attainments from Udaka Ramputra, and Udaka Ramputra is considered as second teacher of Buddha. After learning meditation, he did lot of meditation at Bodh Gaya under Bodhi tree, where he get enlightenment. And after attending enlightenment or Nirvana at the age of 35, Buddha gave his first sermon at Sarnath to his five disciples. In his first sermon, he told about four noble truths. The four noble truths are sorrow. Second one is desire cause sorrow. Third one is conquering desire to end sorrow. And fourth one is eightfold path to end sorrow. In eightfold path, he told about right vision, right determination, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, and right meditation. Buddha preached most of his sermon at Shravasti. He preached his last sermon to the masses at Vaisali. And Buddha preached his last sermon to a disciple, Subhadra, and it was Kushinagar. But in objective question, if it asks where did Buddha give his last sermon, then the answer will be Vaisali, because they generally ask for where did Buddha give his last sermon to the masses. So it was Vaisali. Buddha was cremated at Ramabhar Stup. On the request of his favorite disciple Ananda, Buddha allowed females to join Buddhism. And the first female to endorse Buddhism was Prajapati Gautami, and she was foster mother of Gautam Buddha. Second female to join Buddhism was Amrapali. People were accepted by Buddhist order without consideration of caste, creed, and sex. Anyone can join Buddhist Sangh, but soldiers, slaves, and debaters were not allowed to join Buddhist Sangh. In Buddhism, there is three ratna or three jewel of Buddhism known as Buddha, Sangha, and Dhamma. Now we will start with Buddhist philosophy. Unlike Jainism, Buddhism did not recognize the existence of God and soul. And Buddhism also rejects the caste system introduced by Aryan. Instead of soul and other philosophical stuff, Buddha focused on worldly problem. For salvation from samsara, from birth cycle, Buddha told about four noble truths and eightfold path for salvation. Buddha suggested a middle path for salvation. It was neither too luxurious nor too ascetic. Buddha also laid down code of conduct for his followers, same as Jainism. The five code of conduct were non-violence, truth, non-stealing of others' property, no use of intoxicants, and no sexual misconduct. Buddhist Council. The four major Buddhist council happened in past, and it was listed in this slide. The first council happened just after the death of Buddha in 483 BC at Rajgir, under the leadership of Mahakasyap. The king who gave patronage to this council was Ajatasatru, and is in this council compilation of Sut Pitak by Yananda and Vinaya Pitak by Upali took place. The second council happened around 383 BC at Vaisali under the leadership of Sabhakami, and the king was Kalaso. In this council was called to resolve dispute over Vinaya Pitak, and after this council different school emerged from Buddhism, and there was sect split. The two different school emerged were known as Isthavari Nikaya and Mahasanghika. The third Buddhist council happened in 247 BC at Pataliputra under the leadership of Mogliputra Tissa, and the king at that time was Ashok. In this council, compilation of Abhidhamma Pitak took place. And the compilation was done by Mogliputra Tissa. Mogliputra Tissa wrote a book, Katha Vattu, and it was part of Abhidhamma Pitak. The fourth Buddhist council happened around 102 AD at Kundalgram, Kashmir, under the leadership of Vasumitra. He was monk of Shravastivadian school, and at that time king was Kanishk. In this council, a division in Buddhism happened, and Hinayana and Mahayana emerged from Buddhism. Asoghos of Mahayana participated in this council. In second Buddhist council, the Sangha got split into two different sect or school. The first one is Isthavir Nikaya and second one is Mahasanghika. And between the second Buddhist council and third Buddhist council, there were 18 different schools that were emerged from these two main schools. Under Isthaviras, Shravastivada, Vibhajyavada, Vibhajyavadin, also known as Theravada, Dharmaguptaka, पुगालवादा और वष्टिपुत्रिया, स्वतांत्रिका, सन्नगारिका, सामित्या एंड महिषासका. अंडर महासंगिका स्कूल, एट स्कूल इमर्ज. फर्स्ट वन इज एक व्यवहारिका, सेकंड इज लोकोतारवादा, थर्ड गोकुलिका, फोर्थ बाहुश्रुतिया, फिफ्थ प्रजनपतिवादा, सिक्स कैथिया, सेवेंथ पूर्वशिला एंड एट्थ वन इज अपार शिला. किंग अशोक वॉज रिलेटेड टू विभज्यवादिन स्कूल और थेरावाड़ा स्कूल. ही किंग अशोक हैड सेंट थ्री पितक विथ हिज सन महेंद्र एंड डॉटर संगमित्रा टू श्रीलंका, एंड ही सेंट देम टू स्प्रेड बुद्धिज्म इन श्रीलंका. And it was mentioned in Mahavasma text of Buddhism. And at that time, Sri Lanka was ruled by King Devanampiya Tissa. Sanghamitra planted a Bodhi tree at the Anuradhapura, and Anuradhapura was the capital of Sri Lanka kingdom at that time. After the third Buddhist council organized by King Ashok, more school emerged from these two schools. In Chinese text written by Chinese traveler, there is mention of more than 20 schools. With the passing of time, many schools disappeared, and in four Buddhist council, only few schools were survived. One of the surviving school was Mahayana. It was branch of Mahasanghika, and the Mahayana school started mentioning other surviving school as Hinayana or Sarvakayana. And with further passing of time, only Theravada branch of Hinayana survived. And after that, Theravada was used as synonyms to Hinayana. A new school, Zen, originated in China from Mahayana Buddhism during the Tang Dynasty. And in India, at the time of Gupta Age, a new school emerged from Mahayana Buddhism, and it was known as Vajrayana or Tantric Buddhism. Beside the study of major Mahayana texts, the Vajrayana follower used to study Kanjur and Tanjur text also. In modern times, B.R. Ambedkar gave reinterpretation of Buddhism, and it is known as the fifth school as Navayana. So Hinayana, Mahayana, Jain school, Vajrayana and Navayana. There was five different school in modern times. So Buddhist philosophy of early Buddhist school. According to early Buddhist school, there are 10 fetters or chain that bound a human being to this world or samsara. So these 10 fetters or chain is identity view or non-self. Second one is doubt in Buddha. Third one is ascetic and ritual rules. Fourth one is sensual desire. Fifth one is ill will. Sixth is material rebirth desire. Seventh is immaterial rebirth desire. Eighth is conceit arrogance. Ninth is restlessness. And tenth is ignorance. So in early Buddhist school, they give the philosophy of awakening in four stages. The four stages are mentioned as in this slide. The first stage is Sotapanna, and its meaning is stream entrant. And it was Sotapanna is the person who cut the first three fetters by joining Dhamma. So when a person joined Dhamma, he cut the first three fetters or chain: the identity view, doubt in Buddha, and ascetic and ritual rules. So, and the second stage of awakening was Sakadagami, and its meaning is returning once. Only one more rebirth for those who weakened the fourth and fifth chain. The third stage of awakening was Anagami, or non-returning. So no rebirth for those who cut down the first five chain: identity view, doubt in Buddha, ascetic and ritual rules, sensual desire and ill will. The fourth stage and final stage of awakening for Nirvana is Arhant. A person who achieved Nirvana but not the Buddhahood. And these are those persons who abandoned all 10 fetters, who cut down the all 10 chains. So from early Buddhist school, two important school emerged, that is known as Hinayana and Mahayana. In this slide, we will see the difference between Hinayana and Mahayana. The term Hinayana and Mahayana were originated in the Prajnaparamita Sutra. हीनयान इज नोन एज लेसर व्हीकल एंड महायान इज नोन एज ग्रेटर व्हीकल. इन हीनयान बुद्धा इज कंसिडर्ड एज ऑर्डिनरी ह्यूमन बींग, बट इन महायान बुद्धा इज कंसिडर्ड एज गॉड. इन हीनयान द बुद्धा स्टैचू इज अनअडॉर्न्ड आइडल और अनअडॉर्न्ड स्टैचू एंड एम्फेसिस वॉज पुट ऑन डिसिप्लिन्ड लाइफ, बट इन महायान दे पुट द एम्फेसिस ऑन आइडल वर्शिप. द हीनयान टेक्स्ट वेयर रिटन इन पाली स्क्रिप्चर वाइल द महायान टेक्स्ट वेयर रिटन इन संस्कृत लैंग्वेज. द इन हीनयान द कॉन्सेप्ट वॉज ऑफ पर्सनल इनलाइटमेंट, बट इन महायान द कॉन्सेप्ट वॉज ऑफ पर्सनल एंड मास इनलाइटमेंट. ए बोधिसत्व कैन वर्क फॉर द इनलाइटमेंट ऑफ मास, नॉट ओनली फॉर हिमसेल्फ बट कैन वर्क टू फॉर मास इनलाइटमेंट. इन हीनयान द फोर इमेजरेबल एटीट्यूड इज लव, कंपेशन, जॉय एंड इक्वानिमिटी. द सेम फोर इमेजरेबल एटीट्यूड वॉज मैंशन बाई महायान, बट द इंटरप्रटेशन और मीनिंग ऑफ जॉय एंड इक्वानिमिटी वॉज गिवन डिफरेंट बाई हीनयान एंड महायान स्कूल. इन महायान बुद्धा वॉज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई थ्री डिफरेंट बॉडी. फर्स्ट वन इज निर्मन काया और फिजिकल बॉडी, सेकेंड वन इज संभोग काया और स्पिरिचुअल बॉडी, थर्ड वन इज धर्म काया और अल्टीमेट रियलिटी. बट इन हीनयान देयर इज नो सच कॉन्सेप्ट. इन हीनयान देयर आर 10 परमिताज फॉर बुद्धाहुड. An arhant has to perfect 10 paramitas for Buddhahood, but in Mahayana there is 6 paramitas for Buddhahood. So in UPSC 2020 they asked 10 paramitas. They asked what is meant by what is the meaning of paramitas, and they gave 4 options for it. So it was related to perfection in Buddhism. The Hinayan Buddhism, the follower of Hinayan Buddhism can be found in Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Thailand, Laos and Cambodia. And the follower of Mahayan Buddhism can be found in China, Korea, Japan, Tibet, Vietnam, Nepal and Bhutan. Buddhist text. The Buddhist text is divided in two branches. One is canonical text and second one is non-canonical text. In canonical text, it is canonical text is Tripitak, written in Pali. The first Pitak is Sut Pitaka, second is Vinaya Pitaka, and third one is Avidhamma Pitaka. In Sut Pitaka, sermon of Buddha is written down. In Vinaya Pitaka, code of conduct for monks is compiled, and in Abhidhamma Pitaka, philosophy of Buddha is written down. In Sut Pitaka, there is compilation of 5 books. First one is Dignikaya, second Majjhimika Nikaya, next is Samyutta Nikaya, then Kudaka Nikaya, and then Anguttara Nikaya. In Anguttara Nikaya, there is mention of 16 Mahajanapad at the time of Buddha. The Vinaya Pitak text is divided into three parts. The first one is Sut Vibhang. It is further divided into Mahavibhang and Bhikkhuni Vibhang. Second one is Kandaka. It is further divided into Mahavagga and Kulavagga. Third one is Parivara. Abhidhamma Pitak is divided into 7 parts. First one is Dhammasangani. Second is Vibhang, third one is Dhatukatha, fourth is Pugalpanati, fifth is Kathavattu, sixth is Yamaka, seventh was Pathana. In non-canonical text, the non-canonical texts were written into different language, Pali, Sanskrit, and in some other language. So the Pali text of non-canonical Buddhism are Visuddhimagga, written by Buddha Ghosa, Jatak tales is a compilation of previous life stories of Buddha, then Avadhana. In Avadhana, there was correlation between past karma and present life. They tried to correlate how the past karma is affecting the present life. Past karma of previous lives are affecting the present life. The third one is Milind Pano by Nagsen. The fourth is Deepvasma and Mahavasma. And Deepvasma and Mahavasma was Sri Lankan text. It also gives the glimpse of society in Sri Lanka at that time. The non-canonical text of Sanskrit language are Abhidharma Kosa, and it was Encyclopedia of Buddhism written by Vasu Bandhu. And a scholar Asu Ghosh wrote many Sanskrit texts, and four of the important work of Asu Ghosh are Buddha Charitra, it was biography of Buddha, Sundarananda, a poem that it mentioned about how Nanda converted to Buddhism. Fourth one is Sutralankara. Third work of Asu Ghosh was Sutralankara, and fourth work of Asu Ghosh was Vajra Suchi. And Vajra Suchi is poetry on caste system and iniquity. Mahavastu is the non-canonical text of Buddhism, and it was written in mixed language, Sanskrit, Pali, and Prakrit language. And in this story, Jatak story and Avadhana were compiled together. Bodhisattva. Bodhisattva is one who generated the Bodhicitta to attain Buddhahood. So even the previous life birth of Buddha is known as Bodhisattva. The three Bodhisattva that were depicted with Buddha statue are Avalokiteshvara or Padmapani. And it is Bodhisattva of compassion, and it was represented by the Padmapani Bodhisattva holds a lotus in his hand. And the second Bodhisattva depicted around Buddha statue is Vajrapani, and it is Bodhisattva of power. The Vajrapani Bodhisattva holds thunderbolt in his hand. The third Bodhisattva depicted with Buddha statue was Manjushri, and it is Bodhisattva of wisdom. Manjushri holds book in one hand and sword in another hand. The other Bodhisattva was Akashgarbha, or Bodhisattva of happiness. It is associated with element of space. Kistigarbha, Bodhisattva of great force, and it is considered as guardian of children. And Kistigarbha is twin of Akashgarbha. Vasudhara, or Bodhisattva of fertility, it is popular in Nepal. Skanda, guardian of dharma. Samantabhadra represent practice and meditation of all Buddha. Sitatpatra, goddess to protect from supernatural danger. And Maitri is considered as future Buddha. No. बोधिसत्व ऑफ वज्रयान स्कूल तारा 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 इज फीमेल डीटी डाइटी एसोसिएटेड विथ सक्सेस एंड अचीवमेंट इन वज्रयान स्कूल द वज्रपाणी बोधिसत्व इज डिपिक्टेड विथ फाइव डिफरेंट बोधिसत्व द फर्स्ट वन इज वैरोकाना सेकेंड इज अक्षोभया थर्ड इज अमिताभ दैट इज बोधिसत्व ऑफ इनफाइनाइट लाइट फोर्थ इज रत्न संभवा एंड फिफ्थ इज अमोघ सिद्धि नाउ वी विल लर्न अबाउट प्रोमिनेंट बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क नागसेन ही लिव्ड अराउंड 150 BC एंड ही वॉज श्रावस्तीवादन मॉन्क ही एंसर्ड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ मिएंडर और किंग मिलिंद एन इंडो ग्रीक किंग And the conversation is recorded in the book Milind Panu, written in Pali language. The Sanskrit version of Milind Panu is Nagsen Bhikkhu Sutra. Another important scholar was Asughosa. He lived around 1st century AD and he was follower of Mahayana Buddhism. He wrote Buddha Charit in Sanskrit and he was contemporary of Kanishka. Another scholar of Buddhism was Nagarjun. He lived around 2nd century AD and he was follower of Mahayana Buddhism. He was the founder of Madhyamaka school of Mahayana. Vasubandhu, he lived around 4th century AD and he was follower of Mahayana Buddhism. He wrote Abhidharmakosha, Encyclopedia of Buddhism. He wrote it in Sanskrit language. Buddhaghosa, he lived around 5th century AD and he was follower of Theravada Buddhism and he was from Sri Lanka. He wrote Visuddhi Magga in Pali language. Bodhidharma was lived around 5th to 6th century AD. He was responsible for transmitting Buddhism to China. He started Shaolin Kung Fu. So Kung Fu was a part of Indian tradition that Bodhidharma transmitted to China. Padmasambhava, he lived around 8th century AD and he was follower of Vajrayana Buddhism and he was considered as second Buddha in Tibet, Nepal and Bhutan. Buddhist monk from China who visited India, Kumarajiva, he lived around 4th century AD. He introduced the Madhyamaka school in China. The Madhyamaka school was founded by Nagarjun and Kumarajiva translated many Sanskrit Buddhist texts into Chinese language. Faiyan came to India around 402 AD. He came via land route Kashmir and left via sea route Bengal and he only visited the North India. And he also visited Sri Lanka and he stayed there for 2 years. He visited India during the rule of Chandragupta II or Chandragupta Vikramaditya. He visited Nalanda, but at that time Nalanda University was not established. Nalanda University was established later by Kumaragupta. The travelogue of Paiyan is known as Record of Buddhist Kingdoms or Pho Choki. In his travelogue, he wrote about the caste system in India. Wensang. He came to India in 629 and he stayed in India up to 15 years. So he left India around 645 AD. He came via land route and also left via land route through Kashmir. During his journey, he was attacked by the robbers. He came to India during the reign of King Harshvardhan, Pulkesin II and Mahendravardhan I. He studied at Nalanda University, where he met Shilabhadra. Shilabhadra was yoga kara teacher, and he became the personal teacher of Huyensang. Huyensang visited different parts of India, including Amravati and the capital of Pallav dynasty, Kanchi. In Amravati, he learned Abhidhamma Pitaka. He also visited the kingdom of Sikkim. He attended King Bhaskar Varman court on the request of King Bhaskar. He recorded his 15-year experience in India in his book, Siyuki. And in his book, he mentioned about Chandal and untouchable caste system in his writing. Aisin, he came to India around 675 AD. He came via sea route via Indonesia to Bengal. He studied at Nalanda University, and he visited only Bengal region only, and left Buddhist architecture. In Buddhist architecture, we find stoop, chet and vihar, and statue. The stoop was Vedic age culture, but it was popularized by Buddhism. Chet and vihar are cave architecture emerged during Mauryan times. There are different Buddhist statue made by Gandhar School of Art, Mathura School of Art, and Amravati School of Art. The important learning center of Buddhism was where Takshashila, Nalanda, Odantpuri, and Vikramshila. The Takshashila was in Pakistan, rest three, Nalanda, Odantpuri, and Vikramshila, was in Bihar. The Takshashila was founded by Bharat. Bharat was brother of Lord Rama, and it was the Takshashila was founded in 700 BC by Lord Ram brother Bharat, and Nalanda was founded by Kumargupta first in 427 AD. Odantpuri was founded by Gopala I in 8th century AD, and Vikramshila was founded by Dhanpala in 8th century AD. And these learning centers were attacked by foreign invaders who destroyed these learning center. The Takshashila was destroyed by Huns in 5th century AD, and rest three are destroyed by Turkish invader. Bakhtiar Khilji attacked Nalanda, Odantpuri, and Vikramshila and destroyed these learning center of Buddhism. Stoop. Stoop is Burial Mound. Stoop is Burial Mound prevalent in India from Vedic period. Although stoop was a Vedic tradition, but it was popularized by Buddhism. And earlier stupas were made up of woods, and after that stupa were made up of wood bricks, and then stone stupa came into culture. So yeah, earliest stupa were made up of wood, and then brick made stupas, and then stone made stupas. After the death of Buddha, nine stupas were erected in Gangetic Plains. In eight stupas, there is relic of Buddha, and in one stupa, there is a pot with ashes of Lord Buddha. The places of nine stupas are Rajkri, Vaisali, Kapilvastu, Alakappa, Ramagrama, Vethapida, Pava, Kusinagar, and Piplivana. The textual tradition also mentioned construction of various other stupa on the relic of Buddha at several places, including Avanti and Gandhara, which which were outside the Gangetic Valley at that time. During Ashokan time, the art of stupa reached its climax. Around 84,000 stupas were erected during his time, and most of the stupa were brick stupa. The foundation of Amravati stupa was led by the great Mahadeva Bhikshu, and he was emissary of Emperor Ashok. Some important point about Buddhist stupas. And largest Buddhist stupa in the world is Kesariya Buddha stupa. Lord Buddha cremated here at Rambhar stupa or Muktabandhan Chaitya, and it was built by Malla people after cremation of Lord Buddha. And on the request of Shakya clan, from which Lord Buddha belongs, the Malla people gave the relic of Lord Buddha to Shakya clan, and the Shakya clan built Piprahva stupa around 5th century BC, and it was brick stupa. And this Piprahva stupa is oldest surviving stupa in the world, and oldest stone stupa is Sanchi stupa. Sanchi stupa was built by Ashok, during Mauryan time, most of the stupa were constructed with the help of brick, but Sanchi stupa is stone stupa, and it is oldest surviving stone stupa. Stupa where Buddha gave first sermon, Dhamek stupa, and it was originally built by Ashoka, but later some other ruler rebuilt it. Stupa made by Kanishk, King Kanishk, was Peshawar stupa. Design, how stupa looks. In this figure you can see there is a base known as Methi. Under Methi the relics of Buddha were placed, and over the base there is Anda. And above Anda there is Harmika, and above Harmika you will find Yasti and Chhatras, and around Anda you will find ambulatory passage. In this figure you can see upper walkway, and it was surrounded by wall, the entrance was known as Torrens. Gateway is known as Torrens. In Mauryan time, there was no Torrens. Torrens were added by Sung dynasty. Torren and Medhi are decorated with various motifs like Jatak tales and other stories. Cave architecture, Chet and Vihar. Chet refers to a shrine, sanctuary, temple or prayer hall in Indian religions. Most early example of Chet that survives are Indian rock cut architecture. Chet have a gigantic hall with high vaulted roof with lot of sculpture work on the pillar and the entrance. The largest Chet Grih among all Buddhist monument in India is Karle Cave. Many Chet shows a stupa at the back. Chet were carved either as rectangular hall or apsidal vault roof or apsidal vault pillarless hall. Vihar. Originally, Vihar were dwelling place used by wandering monks during the rainy season. But eventually it got evolved into the center of learning and Buddhist architecture through the donation of wealthy lay Buddhists. The earliest Vihar were made for Ajivak sect. Life in Vihars was codified under Pali canon Vinaya Pitak. टिपिकल लार्ज साइट सच एज अजंता केव, औरंगाबाद केव, काली केव एंड कन्हारी केव कंटेन सेवरल विहार्स। द मॉडर्न पीरियड विटनेस द इमर्जेंस ऑफ रॉक कट केव आर्किटेक्चर। ड्यूरिंग द मॉडर्न पीरियड दीज केव्स वेयर जनरली यूज एज विहार्स एंड द अर्लिएस्ट विहार वेयर मेड फॉर द अजीवक सेक्ट। लेटर ऑन डिफरेंट डायनेस्टी इन डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया कंट्रीब्यूटेड टू केव आर्किटेक्चर। सो वी विल सी केव आर्किटेक्चर इन क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर। सो वी विल सी केव आर्किटेक्ट वी विल सी फर्स्ट केव आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ मौर्यन टाइम्स। इन मौर्यन टाइम्स किंग अशोका मेड बराबर केव्स इन बिहार। दीज आर फोर केव्स एंड इट वॉज बिल्ड अंडर द पेट्रोनेज ऑफ अशोक। द नेम ऑफ द फोर्थ के फोर केव्स आर लोमस ऋषि केव फॉर अजीवक सेक्ट, सुदामा केव, विश्वामित्र केव एंड करण चौपार केव। एंड इन बिहार देयर इज नागार्जुनी केव close to Barabar cave. There are three caves and that were built under the patronage of Dasharath, grandson of Ashok. And these Nagarjuni caves were built for Ajivak Seth. Junagadh caves in Gujarat. These caves are Buddhist cave built from Ashokan times to 4th century AD. So different dynasty contributed to Junagadh cave development. After Mauryan time, Satvahana contributed to cave architecture and most and they made lot of Buddhist cave in Maharashtra region. The first one is Ajanta cave in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra. There is 29 Buddhist cave. Out of 29 Buddhist cave, there are 25 vihars and 4 chats. And it is built on Sahyadri range on the bank of Vagora river. And it was built in two phases. First phase was from 200 BC to 1000 BC under Satvahana rulers. The second phase started around 5th century AD and the second phase patronage was given by Harisen Vakatak rulers plus some Chalukyan rulers. Famous mural paintings of Ajanta cave is Jatak tales, Bodhisattva, birth of Buddha, flying Apsara, dying princess. The mention of Ajanta caves can be found in the writings of Vaiyan and Wensang. Aine Akbari of Abul Fazal also mention about Ajanta caves. Mahakali caves, Mumbai. It is 19 Buddhist caves in Udayagiri Hill built from 200 BC to 1680. Pandavleni caves in Nasik. 24 Buddhist caves of Hinayan sect built around 1st century AD. Gautami Balasani, mother of Gautamiputra Satkarni, gave finance for the cave number 3. Bidasa cave, Pune, Buddhist cave built around 1st century AD. Karle cave at Banarghatta in Lonavala. In Karle cave, we found largest rock cut chat of India built around 120 AD. Kanhairi cave, Mumbai. In Kanhairi cave we found second largest chat hall of India. Cave making started during Satvahan times and continued till 9th century AD. The development of Kanhairi caves continued till 9th century AD. And an inscription on Kanhairi cave mention about marriage of Vasishtaputra Satkarni and daughter of Rudradaman I. Bhaj cave, Pune. The Bhaj cave is cave with wooden ceiling. The In the cave, in the rock cut cave, they deployed wooden ceiling, the wooden structure, and it was built around 2nd century AD. Patan Cave, Maharashtra, it was built around 2nd century AD. In Ajanta Cave, we talked about mural painting. So the wall painting is divided into two parts, two major divisions of wall paintings are mural and fresco. Mural is painting directly on wall, and fresco is painting on freshly plastered wall or painting on wet plasters. So in India, in ancient India, we don't find any fresco painting in any of the caves of ancient India. Post Satvahana, the Satvahana ruler contributed the cave architecture development in Maharashtra region, and it was continued even after post Satvahana, and Maharashtra emerged as center of Buddhist cave development. Elephanta Cave in Mumbai, it was built around 5th to 11th century AD and originally a Buddhist site, but later dominated by Shaivites. A cave temple was built by Krishna Raja of Kalchuriya dynasty at Elephanta Cave. Ellora Cave, Maharashtra. There are 34 Buddhist caves, 34 Ellora Cave, Maharashtra, 34 Buddhist cave built around 600, not all Buddhist cave, 34 caves built around 600 to 1000 AD. Out of these 34 caves, 12 are Buddhist caves, 17 are Hindu cave, and 5 are Jain caves. Hindu and Buddhist caves were carved out under Rashtrakut patronage, and Jain caves were carved out under Yadava patronage. Cave 16, Kailash Temple, was built by Krishna I of Rashtrakut dynasty, and it was world largest single monolithic structure. Jogeshwari Cave, Mumbai, it was built around 6th century AD by monk and Brahmin. Montpire or Mandapeshwar Cave, Mumbai, originally Buddhist and Hindu cave, but later Hindu cave were transformed into Christian cave. Bagh Cave, Gwalior, Buddhist cave on southern slope of Vindhyan Range, built under the patronage of Gupta rulers. Cave 4 of Bagh Cave is known as Rang Mahal because of lot of paintings there. So here is the map showing cave architecture in India. So in Bihar region, Barabar Cave was developed by King Ashok, and in Gujarat he contributed for Junagadh Cave. In MP, Bagh Cave was developed by Gupta ruler, and in Maharashtra you can see lot of cave that was developed under Satvahan ruler, and later on Rashtrakut and other contributed to the cave, the Buddhist cave architecture in Maharashtra region. So there are a lot of caves in Mumbai region. So I did not mention individual cave, I only saw where the Mumbai region. So for Kanheri Cave or Mandapeshwar Cave and other caves in Mumbai, you can locate at this point. So in Maharashtra region, you will find Pandavalleni Cave, Ajanta Cave, Ellora Cave, Karle Cave, Vedasa Cave, and Patan Cave. The red dot shows non-Buddhist cave. The Udayagiri Cave was Hindu cave. Here you will find the statue of Varaha Avatar of Vishnu, and it was built by Chandragupta II or Chandragupta Vikramaditya. Udayagiri and Khandgiri Cave, it was Jain cave built by King Kharvel of Odisha. देन बदामी केव हिंदू एंड जैन केव, सीता नवसल केव इन तमिलनाडु, इट वॉज जैन केव. नाउ वी विल सी द स्टैच्यू. इन पोस्ट मॉरियन टाइम थ्री प्रोमिनेंट स्कूल ऑफ स्कल्पचर डेवलप्ड एट थ्री डिफरेंट रीजन ऑफ इंडिया, एंड दीज स्कूल आर नोन एज गंधार स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट, मथुरा स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट एंड अमरावती स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट. सो वी विल सी द पैरामीटर्स एंड हाउ दीज स्कूल आर डिफरेंट. सो गंधार स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट एंड मथुरा स्कूल वॉज आर्ट डेवलप्ड अंडर द पेट्रोनेज ऑफ कुषाण, बट अमरावती स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट डेवलप्ड अंडर द पेट्रोनेज ऑफ सतवाहन रूलर्स. द लोकेशन ऑफ दिस स्कूल आर सेम एज द नेम ऑफ स्कूल. द गंधार स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट डेवलप्ड इन गंधार रीजन, मथुरा स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट डेवलप्ड इन मथुरा रीजन एंड अमरावती स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट डेवलप्ड इन अमरावती एंड नागार्जुन कोंडा रीजन. इन गंधार स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट वी फाउंड ग्रीक और हेलेनिस्टिक इन्फ्लुएंस, बट इन मथुरा एंड अमरावती स्कूल ऑफ आर्ट वी डोंट फाइंड एनी फॉरेन इन्फ्लुएंस. इट वॉज indigenously developed school. The religion in Gandhar school of art we only found Buddhist statue, but in Mathura school of art we found Hindu, Jain and Buddhist statue, and in Amravati school of art we found only Buddhist statue. The material used for making statue at Gandhar School of Art were grey sandstone and mud and stucco. In Mathura School of Art, red sandstone were used for making a statue, and in Amravati, white marble were used. The theme of Gandhar School of Art was Buddha, spiritual Buddha. In Mathura, it was delighted Buddha with Bodhisattva. In Amravati School of Art, you will find a narrative story or Jatak tales depicted by statue. The feature of Gandhar School of Art. In Gandhar School of Art, Buddha is seated in position of yogi and more emphasis on mustache, muscles and curly hairs. And in Gandhar School of Art, the Buddha eyes is half closed for meditation. And there is hollow around Buddha head, and it was less decorated in Gandhar School of Art. In Mathura School of Art, Buddha is seated in Padmasan, and in this school more emphasis was put on internal beauty and facial sentiments. Buddha was the garments of Buddha was tightly fit in Mathura School of Art, and the halo around Buddha head was lavishly adorned. In Satvahan School of Art, the theme was narrative story or Jatak tells. So the statue was built with depicting lot of people, and not only Buddha but lot of people around him. So less emphasis was put on Buddha, and the bodies of people are shown in Tribhang position in Amravati School of Art. So in Gandhari School of Art and Mathura School of Art, Buddha is shown in different mudra, and these mudra are based on hand gesture. So we will see the mudra in the chronological order of life of Buddha. First one is Anjali mudra, and Anjali mudra is for Bodhisattva who aims for enlightenment. So he can the Anjali mudra is same as Namaste mudra. You can see the image. The Buddha who is wishing for enlightenment is seated in Anjali mudra. It was only for Bodhisattva, the person who attained Buddha, who did not show this hand gesture. Second one is Dhyan Mudra, and this mudra is used by Buddha during the final meditation under the Bodhi tree before enlightenment. And this the Dhyan Mudra is shown in figure where Buddha is seated in Padmasana with both hand is on his lap. The third mudra is Bhumi Sparsh Mudra, and Buddha saw this hand gesture when at the moment when Buddha attained enlightenment. And the significance of this mudra is calling the earth to witness the truth. You can see in the image that the one hand of Buddha is trying to touch the earth, is touching the earth. The fourth mudra is Abhayless or Fearless Mudra, and this was the gesture shown by Buddha immediately after attaining enlightenment. And you can see the image where the hand of Buddha is raised up to his shoulder. Fifth one is Uttar Bodhi Mudra, and it shows supreme enlightenment. You can see how the two hands are joined together, and the finger of both the hands are touching each other. Vajra Mudra. The Vajra Mudra represent knowledge or supreme wisdom, something like enlightenment. And this mudra is shown in Korean and is prevalent in Korea and Japan region. In this mudra, the knowledge is represented by finger of one hand, and another hand hold this finger or hold the knowledge. You can see the image of Vajra Mudra, and in that figure you can see Buddha looks like Chinese or Japanese or Korean, looks like Korean or Japanese people. Seventh is Dharmachakra Mudra, and Dharmachakra Mudra is when Buddha preached, he saw this hand gesture was shown by Buddha when he preached his first sermon. You can see the image of Dharmachakra Mudra, and in Dharmachakra Mudra both hand the fingers of both hand are joined to make zero figure. You can see the image. Vitarka Mudra. The Vitarka Mudra is for intellectual debate and discussion. You can see in the image that one hand of Buddha is on lap, and another one hand is raised with two fingers making figure like zero. Vardha Mudra. Vardha Mudra is for granting wishes. You can see the image where Lord Buddha is in standing position, and you can see the hand gesture. Both the hands are open outward. So this mudra is to grant wishes to his follower. Karan Mudra, it was to ward off evil and negative thought. You can see in the image that the one hand is in lap of is in the lap of Lord Buddha, and another hand makes figure of zero with two fingers. Reclining Buddha, it represent last illness before parinirvana or death of Buddha. The first reclining Buddha statue was made at Gandhari School of Art. And in reclining Buddha statue, Buddha was shown in horizontal way. He was lying on the bed. In 2021, India's largest reclining Buddha statue of 100 feet was installed at Bodh Gaya. The world's largest reclining Buddha statue was Twaya Buddha of 600 feet at मोवल मियान इन म्यांमार। सो इन लास्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट डिक्लाइन ऑफ बुद्धिज्म। इन 254 BC तिसार का अशोक क्वीन डिस्ट्रॉयड द ओरिजिनल बोधि ट्री इन बोध गया व्हेन अशोक वाज आउट ऑफ मगध। एंड सी डिड दिस बिकॉज सी वाज नॉट इन फेवर ऑफ इन सी बिकॉज सी डिड नॉट लाइक दैट अशोक ज्वाइन बुद्धिज्म। एंड मैनी डिफरेंट रूलर अपोज द बुद्धिज्म एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंट नेम दैट अपोज द बुद्धिज्म आर पुसिमुत्रिसुंग एंड मिहिरकुल। दे स्टार्ट प्रोसिक्यूशन ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क। द सेवाइट किंग ससांक ऑफ गौड फेल्ड द बोधि ट्री इन 7th century AD। इन स्टार्टिंग बुद्धिज्म इज अबाउट रिफॉर्म बट इवेंचुअली इट सकम्स टू द रिचुअल एंड सेरेमनीज इट ओरिजिनली डिनाउंस एंड एट द सेम टाइम ब्राह्मण रिफॉर्म दियर रिलीजन। सो पीपुल मोर पीपुल गेट अट्रैक्टेड टू हिंदू रिलीजन देन बुद्धिज्म। एंड बुद्धिज्म मोंक स्टार्टेड द यूज ऑफ संस्कृत लैंग्वेज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ पाली एंड इंट्रोड्यूस आइडियल वर्शिप ऑन ए लार्ज स्केल। दे स्टार्ट टेकिंग ऑफरिंग फ्रॉम डिवोटीज एंड दिस लेड टू चेंज इन द नेचर ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट मोनास्ट्रीज। मोंक बिकम इजी लविंग एंड करप्ट एंड इनॉर्मस वेल्थ ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट मोनास्ट्रीज अट्रैक्ट फॉरेन इन्वेडर्स। टर्किश इन्वेडर डिस्ट्रॉय नालंदा एंड विक्रमशिला इन 12th century AD एंड बाई द एंड ऑफ 12th century AD बुद्धिज्म बिकम वर्चुअली एक्सटिंक्ट फ्रॉम इंडिया। रिगार्डिंग बोधि ट्री द फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट टू डिस्ट्रॉय द बोधि ट्री वॉज डन बाई क्वीन तिसारका। सी वॉज क्वीन ऑफ अशोका। सी कट डाउन द ट्री बट द बोधि ट्री इमर्ज फ्रॉम द रूट एंड सेकेंड टाइम द बोधि ट्री वॉज कट डाउन बाई किंग ससांका एंड ही पुट द एंड ही सेट द रूट ऑन फायर सेट द रूट ऑफ बोधि ट्री ऑन फायर। But again, the Bodhi tree emerged from the root, and in British India time, the Bodhi tree was lost because of natural calamities. In 1881, Lord Cunningham bring the branch of Bodhi tree from Anuradhapuram, and he planted it at the current place of Bodhi tree. So the present Bodhi tree at Bodh Gaya was planted by Lord Cunningham, and it was planted with the help of branch of Bodhi tree from Anuradhapura, Sri Lanka. So I will end my lecture here. Thank you.